What's going on, Legion? Azure here, and we are back on a Thursday with some more Fourth Impact. Now, we had an American holiday. It was Labor Day Monday, which meant I skipped Monday, recorded everything on a Tuesday, thinking I had a whole nother day before I had to record for Wednesday. Didn't realize that Wednesday was the next day, and, well, here we are. I was uploading videos yesterday, and I go, wait, what is today? And I checked, I was like, oh shit, I was already done uploading half the stuff I was uploading. And I had, when you wake up at 11 in the afternoon or morning, and then you have to do videos and comments and stuff, and then you start doing other things like live streaming at 2:30, there isn't enough time to record stuff, get it right, get it labeled, get all the links and whatever, upload it, get that situated, and then it's just a hassle. It really is. So I decided I have to bite one for the team, take the bullet, and upload on a Thursday. I'm sorry if everybody was coming on Wednesday going, Fourth Impact! I know, the holiday really messed up my schedule. So sorry. But this will not be a reoccurring thing. Wednesdays are usually the days I just kind of settled on. I didn't pick this day for any specific reason. Just picked Wednesday, and it just stuck. Wednesdays and Sundays is when I do most of the music. And I don't think we're going to have a whole lot of music like last week. We had, hopefully, last week, and the fact that we had a crap ton of music throughout the entire week. We had it on Sunday, Tuesday, Friday, or Thursday, and then Saturday and Sunday, I believe. So hopefully with all the music I had and stuff like that, it really made up for everybody else. So with that being said, though, we are back with Fourth Impact. This is the fourth week, I believe. And I didn't have my headset on. I didn't hear anything, but I was making sure it's the right video. And they were on, like, pantsuits. Not the most attractive thing, but let's see if they can pull it off. So with that being said, let's get into it. Check it out. See what it's all about. Let's hope it's good.
Fourth Impact.
I like when he says that.
Don't do your thing, honey. I can feel it from the start.
The attitude right now, man. I feel like every episode they've had more and more attitude.
Something moved me deep inside. Don't know what you did, boy, but you had it.
Okay, it's a little sexy, right?
So my mother, my brother, my sister, and my faith. So the others, my love.
Dude, this is a good song, man.
Every time I see you, everything starts making sense.
I mean, this is a crazy song to begin with. You're like, oh, nostalgia. But them all singing it together? It's a whole new thing. Oh, cameraman, get it together, bro. You're on international TV. That booty dough. It's like a Valentine's theme or something. I don't know. I see you guys. I see the men pulling it out there. Oh shit, they're doing that little shuffle, man. Oh god, what is this, like 86? See, they talk in the middle of performance. Don't give me shit. Oh, this is like a really good one in a whole different way. It's like my favorite in a whole different direction. Oh, that's awesome. That was just so good. So good. That was like... Oh, that was like top tier, man. It was top tier. It's Simon, we don't need another word from you. We hear enough. Thank you. Wow, I got it. Like, that song in its own right, like... I'm trying to remember the name of it. I have it right here. There ain't no other woman like... I'm trying to remember exactly how the song goes. I remember it's like a it's just as quick as they sang it. It's just as like popular. It was a good song. I mean, it was a popular song. It was just it was a good thing. But when they were singing it together, right in the beginning, when they were all singing it together, let's just re-listen to this part. Just re-listen. This is what really set the tone for the, and this is why timing is everything. Just listen to the beginning. Empire. Not this beginning, but when they all started walking. And she's just really attractive, so she can make anything work, right? Like, see, they all may have the voice and stuff. She has the alluring body movement stuff. She's the very seductive type. Right here. This is the best. Right there. Right there. I'm not going to go through the whole thing again. But right there, that honestly was one of the best moments of any performance they've had on the show. And it set the mood for the entire song. Even if the rest of the song wasn't like... I'm not saying it was. But, you know, there's been performances where there's parts that are really good. And I believe the... No, it may not have been Fourth Impact. It may have been the KZ reaction I was doing, Rolling in the Deep, where I was not a fan of the rapping in that one, or the spitting or whatever, like I was in the other one. And I said, you know, there was moments of that song I really liked, I thought were incredible. And, you know, sometimes when I've watched Got Talent, I watched X Factor, never watched Idol, because who watches Idol? I watched the first 3 seasons, I believe, of The Voice US, which I'm really proud of The Voice, because I believe it was the one that originated in America. Unlike a lot of this other stuff where Simon Cowell is the instrument of our demise and all these other shows, The Voice is something that has swept everywhere. And I honestly think it's the best concept out of, I mean, Got Talent and X Factor was kind of its own thing to kind of say, hey, Idol. But Idol was kind of destroying it until Idol just took a dump. Idol was, I believe, conceived in America as well, but with Simon just taking all this innovation and his ideas didn't even saturate the market. He just made other unique and whatever things, and then The Voice came out and said, "Yo, we see this market of just bullshit and debauchery. Let me get something that is so fresh and so new." And the whole point, I don't watch The Voice anymore because I don't have the time, first of all, nor do I really care anymore. Except that I don't like Miley Cyrus, but she's going to be on the next Voice US. I might check that out a little bit just to see what it's all about. But in all these shows that I've watched, I've seen people have an awesome start to a song and then finish poorly. Like if you're doing track and field and you start out sprinting, but by the end of it, you're gasping, you're dying, you're like, but you still finish first because you hold in there. And sometimes a beginning of a song can be so epic. It can have such an awesome moment that you're like, I don't care if the rest of it was bad or just not the greatest. I'm voting for them. And I've sure as hell done that before. The best part about this performance was the beginning was awesome. I'm not going to say that the ending was like a strong finish. It was good. It wasn't it wasn't as incredible as that opening moment, because that opening moment, like I said, was probably the best moment they've had in any song, except for the last one where they were wearing the Beyonce one, I believe it was, where they were wearing the white dresses and they're doing that hip movement and their legs, and they were really, really attractive in that video. It was straight hot. It was. And so this was, you know, before that, they haven't really gone so insane, but those, what were they, like, tassel-y kind of dresses were like, they weren't even like half, not even past halfway. Those were like mid-thigh dresses, and they're doing the whole, if you're a man, you know what the leg thing is. Watch that performance where they're all gyrating. It's the leg thing. I don't really want to go into more detail than that. But this was, and it's nice to see them go different ways. You know, they didn't rely on trying to be sexy or trying to be. They really started out with a lot of talent. Every audition they had, or everything they were doing, the judge's house and all that stuff, was them wearing a nice top, right? Something that was maybe sparkly, something that they liked, they thought was cute, and sometimes it was like, I don't want to say like pants or. Maybe a skirt or something like that, but it was always very moderate. It wasn't like over the top. They weren't trying to get on the show from this. They were trying to get in show for this and this. That this is important as well. But and I apologize. I don't know all their names as far as individuals, just because I haven't had the time to just. Even then, I don't watch them enough to retain that knowledge. I need to at least watch something a few times, not just weekly, to retain somebody's name or where they're from. I mean, I can understand where they're from. That's not hard. But apologies for that, because I don't know. But the one that was on the closest to the camera when they're all sitting down, like the other one in the far end, you could see she did something. She did the little frown face, which was very attractive, but that it was very just kind of that where it was. But the first one, the youngest one, I believe, she just, and maybe it's because she's the youngest one, she had all the sex appeal in that in that seat. She was working it hard. She was bringing it home. Because now that they made it onto the show without exploiting this, now they can go, okay, there's more than just, you know, you're a performer. You need to sing good. You need to look good. You need to have that allure. As a female singer, you can be like Sia, which has hair that comes down to here, and she stands there, or you just never see her. And her talent is represented through her voice and her art. Completely okay. You know, she doesn't need to go any other route. Sometimes, maybe it's the times, maybe it's the age of who we are nowadays. See, is maybe a little older, or how old these women are. Excuse me. You know, some of them are like 27 or 28, right? Which is around my age range. And when I was growing up, Britney Spears and Christina Aguilera, they took the sex appeal beyond what it ever should have been. It was overflowing with just young boys, and I'll leave it at that. Your imagination can fill the rest in, because I mean, I still think people remember it. It wasn't Genie in a Bottle. I don't believe it was the schoolgirl one where everybody lost their shit. And looking back at it, I'm like, oh, not that attractive to me anymore. But when I was a kid, I was like, damn. And so, they're probably influenced by what that was at the time, but they're very more respectful nowadays. Being religious, probably, they show sex appeal. They have that allure with their eyes, the way they move their mouth, the scrunch of the nose, maybe the way they move their body. But they don't go into raunchiness. They don't go past that, you know, respectable line, which is always really nice to see someone that could be. I think there's a big difference from being attractive and trying to be attractive, you know, and trying to get votes. If they were trying to get votes, I mean, they probably wouldn't go with pantsuits, even though they had like halter tops or midriff shirts, which is just a cute thing that women do, to take something that's very but make it kind of, you know, better. And then, you know, all of that can also be surmised as being a showman. Or show woman, them doing this, them being maybe a little bit more sexy than they want to be, because in this industry, in singing in general, there is, your morals kind of have to balance. You have to balance that stuff out. Their religious beliefs and all that stuff, or whatever it is that they, we don't want to be sexy, has no place in this industry, the entertainment industry, because in the entertainment industry, that is the religion, that is the law. And sometimes if people don't comply with that, or at least accept some things over here but not things over here, you're gone from the industry. You just kind of get blacklisted, or you just get shunned, because you won't play ball is the term. And so I think that they take a very good balancing act from possibly, if they don't want to, it shows that they're doing a pretty good job of keeping it conservative, but also being a show woman or show women. And I think that's pretty respectable. I think that's applaudable that they don't go beyond. Now, maybe later on they do. Maybe they just have an idea. Unless you do Miley Cyrus and you do it more than one time, that's getting a little out there. Sometimes people make decisions where like, let's just do this. And it comes off being like, oh my God, I can't believe they did that. That's not who we know them as. Fourth Impact doesn't dress like this or say these lyrics. What's going on? And it could just be we were trying something new. We had an idea. We thought maybe it'll work and it didn't. Okay, that's one thing. But Miley Cyrus, she did this and then she went, let's just keep doing this over and over again all the time. Let's make this our image. Let's just have a finger and have this weird tight spanky bra thing and hump giraffes and shit. And it's like, you don't get a pass. You're doing this on purpose now. This wasn't just an idea. You're making this decision. So, I think that's where I'll end it that on far as their look. Like I said, the song started out incredible. Maybe nothing except for an overall incredible performance could have made the rest of the song incredible. Because for me, man, I mean, I don't know if you can tell by my smile, but I noticed me smiling. That opening, I was like, hell yeah, dude, this is awesome. It was just a great moment for me. I really enjoyed the song. And I didn't think it was bad or anything at the end of it, but I sure as hell don't think it was as strong as the opening. Because the opening, I think, just hit every note, every criteria, every little thing here that I personally wanted to hear. And the rest of it was just good. It was awesome. I mean, it was still incredible. I don't know why I say good. But I think the opening was just out of this world, and the ending was just incredible. I think that's a good way to leave it there. And I think it was a good performance. Overall, not my favorite performance. I think last week was probably hands down one of the best for sure. But the opening to this one had the best opening out of anything I've heard from them at all. And we've gone on 17 minutes, so apologies for that. I'm going to get out of here. I don't know if there is going to be another music thing. I don't know if it's going to be Fourth Impact. I don't know what it's going to be coming out next. All right. So I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching. Thanks for hanging out. If you like the content, you like the stuff I discuss here, you can like, subscribe, or share. Remember, it's completely up to you. I do appreciate it, though. If you want to leave a comment down below or a link, please. I'd love to see and love to hear all the comments down below in the comment section. Once again, my name is Azure. I'll see you on whatever video I'm doing next. It just may be another Fourth Impact. Who knows? Later.